Sing the chorus this morning. Jesus, we just want to thank you.
Jesus, we just want to thank you.
Turn to number 4 in our hymnal. Number 4.
Glory, strange.
Thank you, and you may be seated.
Leave.
take what's wrong and make it right. Take sunshine on me, let your love shine through me in the night. Take sunshine down on me, let your love shine through me in the night. Jesus, shine down on me, let your love shine through me in the
appreciated that beautiful singing, didn't we? Amen. Praise God. And that's certainly what we need. We need God to help us that we can be a witness. As the song said, talking about a world that's been deceived, Lord, help us to be a witness. Shine down upon us. You know, the darker the night, the brighter the light. And Jesus is faithful to every one of us. Praise the Lord. Thank you, ladies. Beautiful job. Beautiful job. My mind went back to the first time that I'd ever heard that song. Right here in revival meeting. And those that sang it. And my mind began to wonder about where they are now. It behooves all of us, folks. The devil doesn't care how he gets you. Just as long as he gets you, that's what matters. But I'm glad we can keep our head in the nails guarded and our eyes on Jesus. We can make it. Praise God. We can make it. By God's grace and God's help, we can make it. Thank the Lord we can. Amen. And I have purpose within my heart. I'm not going to turn by the wayside. I'm going to stick by the stuff. I'm going to be faithful to God. Amen? There's a church in Indianapolis that I like their advertising. I really do. It's Colonial Baptist Church, and every week it's there, and the heading is Church Like It Used to Be. I like that. Amen. Because God hasn't changed, has He? Amen. Now maybe some of our methods have changed, but God hasn't changed. He's still right where He's always been. Praise God. Thank the Lord for that. Oh, it's so good to see you in God's house this morning. Appreciate that beautiful, beautiful music in God's presence. Stand together, will you please, for the reading of God's Word, found over in the 103rd Psalm. Psalm 103 this morning. Man, the first five verses we want to look at this morning. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits. Who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all of thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles. Then I'd like for you to turn to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5. And verses 16 through 18 this morning also for our text. Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. Heavenly Father, we appreciate the privilege of being in God's house this morning. Lord, don't ever let us take it lightly. The great price that's been paid that we can have liberty, spiritual liberty, Lord, and spiritual freedom, as well as freedom to gather together and worship you this morning. We thank you for it. And we ask that you'll help us in these next few moments as we turn our attention to the things of God and the theme of thanksgiving, that you would help us and that your will can be accomplished in all that we say and do. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you. You may be seated. I want to talk to us this morning for a few minutes on thanksgiving. Grateful to whom? Thanksgiving, grateful to whom? Rejoice evermore. Pray without ceasing. In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. My, what a tremendous text this morning on thanksgiving. One translation says it like this: be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. Now you notice that this translation didn't say give thanks for all circumstances, but it said give thanks in all circumstances. There's a real difference. In the King James, it talks about in everything give thanks. It doesn't talk about the fact that we're thankful for everything that happens, but in everything give thanks. No matter how terrible the circumstances of life may be, with God's help, there is always that which we can be thankful for. Everybody said amen to that? There isn't any one of us here this morning that couldn't stand to begin to thank the Lord for many, many, many things that happen. Even though some things come across our path we don't understand, and things that aren't pleasant, still God is good to us in such a wonderful, wonderful way. Two friends who hadn't seen each other for several years met one day, and they began to fill each other in on what had happened in their lives, and they were visiting together. When one said, I got married a couple years ago, and the other said, oh, that's good. And no, well, not really. Well, why not? Well, my husband's twice as old as I am. Oh, that's bad. Well, not really, for you see, he's a millionaire several times over. Oh, that's good. No, that's not so good, because he turned out to be mean and he won't give me any money at all. Oh, that's bad. Well, that's really not that bad, she said. He did build us a $300,000 house. Oh, that's good. Well, not really, because it burnt down last month. Oh, that's bad. Well, that's not really all bad, because he was in it. So just about whatever circumstance in life comes along, we can be thankful that God is faithful to every one of us. Now this is Thanksgiving week. It just seems like 2 weeks ago we were having Thanksgiving, doesn't it? Is anybody as old as I am around here? It kind of feels that way, I'll tell you. Yeah, I see Gordon putting his hand up. I know he's almost as old as I am. It just seems like... And once your kids are out of the house and you start having those grandkids, I mean, things get busier all the time. It just seems like that you just, I mean, it's just, have you ever thought, Grandpa, what in the world? And I've heard people talk about retiring and they say, I don't know when in the world I had time to go to work. I mean, time just goes on so fast. And here we are at another Thanksgiving time. Now, you can tell it's Thanksgiving when you walk into the grocery store or you walk into Walmart because of all the Christmas stuff. They just can't wait. They tell us that the Friday after Thanksgiving is the number one, the biggest shopping day for Christmas for the whole season, the day after Thanksgiving. Around our house, some of the ladies, they'll get up bright and early the next day and trek off to the mall over there. And you can hardly get through. I want to tell you a little secret. They're not going to buy everything in one day. Why don't you just wait another day and save a lot of elbow grease and skin? from rubbing elbows with all those people out. Well, they tell us on that day there are some people actually get mad and get in fights because they want something somebody else has got, and they got there before they. In fact, you know, when the crazy craze was on some of these dolls, they'd actually sit up all night long and see who could be the first one at the door. So when the door opened, Thanksgiving's here because Christmas is right out there, and they've commercialized Christmas so much until we've just about lost the meaning of Christmas. Lord help us. And during this week, our president, he will issue the annual Thanksgiving proclamation. And our very secular government that almost chokes every time it says the word of God will suddenly project an air of piety and encourage all of us to be thankful at least one day of the year. Haven't we gone so far from the very first Thanksgiving? Huh? Oh, and this week your kids will be coming home from school and they'll be wearing those funny looking hats that they made at school, those pilgrims. I think I told you this, but I thought it was quite interesting. When I was holding revival, Brother Johnson down in Alabama, there was a fellow there that came up to me and he asked me, he said, "Did you ever hear tell the Pilgrim Church?" I said, "Sure." I said, "I was raised in the Pilgrim Church." He said, "You know, that was the first church that was ever established in the United States. The Pilgrim Church." Well, Brother Sutherland and the New York Pilgrim, they'd be pretty happy to know that they were the original. But you know, it's Thanksgiving everywhere you look now. I don't know about you, but have you noticed all the turkeys that are for sale? In fact, somebody here in town had turkeys on sale for 49 cents a pound with a $25 order, and it's been a long time since we've had turkeys for 49 cents a pound. Amen? Thanksgiving is here. Well, I want to encourage you this morning to take two safeguards to protect Thanksgiving. And we want to talk about three things that we need to be reminded of. First of all, make sure that you're thankful to the right somebody. Make sure that you're thankful to the right somebody. And if you're going to say thank you, we must say thank you to somebody and make sure it's the right someone. Harriet, who was an atheist, one morning she and her friend stepped out into the glories of a beautiful fall morning, and she saw how brilliant the sun peeking through the haze and the frost on the meadow and the brightly covered leaves making their way lazily to the ground, and she was filled with beauty and burst forth with, "I'm so thankful," she said. "I'm just so grateful for it all." When her believing friend asked, "Grateful to whom, my dear?" We need to be careful that we're grateful to the God that has brought to us all the many manifold blessings that He's bestowed upon us. Let us not take the thankfulness and thanking man or thanking her. You know, there's some people that they just think, "Well, I've got everything I've got because I was so smart and so shrewd and so sharp." No, I want to tell you something, honey. You've got what you got because God gave you the ability to be able to make and mold and build and do. And we need to thank God for the many manifold blessings of God. And let's be reminded that we need to thank the right person for all the good things that He's done for us. It's a good question at Thanksgiving. If you're grateful, if you're really thankful, then the next question should be, how grateful to whom? I like the story of the lady who pulled up to the drive-in window at the bank. The inside teller, the sun was so bright that he pulled down the shade because he couldn't see as people would come in. And so he pulled down the shade. He could see out, but you couldn't see in. And she went to the teller or to the drive up and rolled the window down and pushed the button, got out that little thing, put a deposit in it, put it back in and pushed the button. It went back inside. The teller on the inside took care of all the business, put back the receipt, and she reached out and got the receipt. And as she started to drive off, she said, "You know," said, "you're probably all automated in there, but I just feel like I need to say thank you to someone." I'll tell you what, that's a good attitude. I'm being thankful to someone. And that someone is Jesus Christ that's been so faithful to all of us. Thinking again of you know, my cousin who was a Sunday school superintendent for 40 years of a holiness church. But it seemed that he just got so busy with life that he kind of slid away from where he ought to be until cancer came along. And when he told my dad, he said, "I am so thankful God has given me this dreadful disease." He said, "Because it slowed me down and I've been able to stop and see where I was and get some things straight in my..." You know what? Even in the midst of whatever God allows across our pathway, it's so good to be thankful to a God that loves us and cares for us and is interested in every need that we have. Well, King David wasn't frustrated, and he was far from it. He knew the answer to the question of gratefulness. If anyone had cause to lift his voice in thanksgiving to God, David was the man. A shepherd boy who became the hero of a nation. A hunted fugitive who became its king. A condemned sinner who became a man after God's own heart. And it isn't any wonder that he began that 103rd Psalm with those words, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercy, who satisfieth my mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagle." So I say again, when you decide to be thankful, be sure that you're like King David and you're thankful to the right somebody. Secondly, let us notice that we need to make sure you thank God for the right reasons. You need to make sure that you thank God for the right reasons. Now, folks, if you were to draw upon a Thanksgiving list for which you are thankful, what would you put on this list? Well, I know there's a few things that I'd put on it. First of all, I'm thankful for the blessing of living in the United States of America. Amen. And I want to tell you, we need to be praying. We need to be praying for our servicemen that are daily giving their life for freedom. Amen. And then to think there's some of them want to persecute those that are trying to do that which is right. That Marine that they're trying to destroy over the fact that he shot an insurgent. I heard a fellow on the radio yesterday, and he was talking about some of these things, and he said, "You know, when you're in the midst of that," and said that adrenaline is flowing, he says that, and that prisoner said he's the worst enemy that you have. He said, until you've been there and done that, you have no idea what that guy's going through. We need to pray. We need to pray. I want to tell you something. The left wing out here that's making all the noise, which mostly is about 90% the media. Huh? I think at the election time, they got their eyes open, and now they're trying to do something else to distract our attention in another direction. God help us. We need to pray for our country. I am so thankful that I live in America. In the United States of America. Amen. I mean, even with the worst that we have, and we know we're not perfect. Amen. We got a long ways to go, but thank God we live in America. I'm so thankful for the privilege of being a citizen of this country. Secondly, despite of all of my aches and pains, I'm thankful for the physical blessings too. Someone says that if you can count your fingers and toes, and if your mind is sharp enough to count that high, then you need to thank God for your mind too. Thank God that we have the ability to move around, and the Lord has blessed us and given us physical strength every day. Thank the Lord for that. You know, in fact, my wife said to me this summer, said, "Honey, I don't know what's doing it, but said you have more strength, it seems like, this summer than you've had in years." Well, thank the Lord. The Lord knew I needed it. He knew we had a lot of work to do, and we needed that strength. And isn't God good to us? Thank God for the physical touch of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I praise Him for that. I thank Him for supplying all of my needs. Amen. No, I don't have everything I'd like to have, but I have everything I need. Some people, they're so holy. Well, I don't have any wants. Well, I really question that. You probably want a mind because you're thinking wrong. You know, we all have wants, don't we? Huh? Sure we do. But thank God He supplies all of our needs. He just knows how to do that. He's so good. We praise Him. And we're reminded that every good and perfect gift comes from God. Amen. I realize the list could go on and on, but for the sake of time, let us look at the list that David wrote here in the 103rd Psalm, beginning with verse 3. He begins by thanking God for being a God who forgives all of our sins. Wow! David knew that that was very important to him. And if there's anything we need to be thankful for, is a God that has forgiven us of all of our sins. Oh, when you go and see the world, the heavy burden of sin that they're carrying around, how dejected and down and depressed that they are. You just want to say, someway, just come to Jesus. He can change all of that. I was in a home just yesterday and visiting and trying to get this individual to come to church, and he began to just pour his heart out to me, and he does have a lot of problems. He really does. But I said, I called him by name, and I said, if you'd only turn it over to the Lord and let God have a chance at it. Amen. I want you to know we need to thank God that He forgives us of all of our sins. May I suggest that the most precious gift that any of us can ever receive is through Jesus Christ, who has provided a way for our sins to be forgiven, and it can be ours if we'll only accept it. King David didn't throw this in here, but I'm going to. I want to thank God for His holiness. I want to thank God that we're serving a whole and a pure, a wholesome God, and a God that has cleansing power that can cleanse the heart of man and fill him with the blessed Holy Spirit, until in this day and age we're living in, we can live above sin and have the power to live above sin. Amen. I want you to know there's something to heart holiness. Amen. God knows how to take out that old nature of sin and fill you with the blessed Holy Spirit, until when some things in life come along, you can still be sweet about it. And I want you to know that He has a work of grace until you can love everybody, whether they love you or not. And I'm thankful this morning. I'm thankful that I heard about holiness of heart. Thank God for God that can save us from sin, and for God that can take the sin out of us. Then he says that God heals all of our diseases. Now, David didn't know much about germs or infection. All he knew was that when the people of Israel obeyed God's law, that they didn't have the plagues and the land of waste and the nations around about them. And when the troubles did arise, they called upon God for help, and He was always there to help them. Now, you may not be able to understand everything that's happening in your life, but I'm convinced that God is the great physician, and He knows the deepest needs of my life better than I know myself. And whether my needs is physical or psychological or spiritual, I'm sure that God will always do the best for me. And I'm thankful that He does. I mentioned a while ago, thankful for His strength that He gives us day by day. Praise God. I want you to know, even when you get ready to cross the Chili Jordan, He'll be there to give you strength for that day too. He's a good God. Heals all of our diseases. Next, David says that God redeemed your life from the pit and crowned you with love and compassion. And God certainly did that for David, and He's still doing that today. Then he says that God satisfies your desires with good things, so that your youth is renewed like eagles. I like that. Almost everybody that I know is searching for a fountain of youth. Amen. Amen. I mean, there isn't anybody here. If I tell you I'm going to give you something and this will make you feel good and make you feel young again, why, your hands would be up in the air all over this place. Now, some of you might be too tight to buy it, but if I'd give it to you, your hands would be up. Everybody's looking for that fountain of youth. But I'm a realist. And I know that when I stand in the mirror, I realize I wasn't born with gray hair, poor eyesight, or wrinkles that I now have. And maybe Paul explained it the best when he said, wasting away on the outside, but the inside were renewed day by day. We've been talking to the young people at school about eagles. And this week, the lesson was talking about eagles. When eagles get old, they grow new feathers. Amen? And I'll tell you something else that we found out about eagles, that eagles always fly alone. They have the courage to stand up. They always fly alone. And eagles, when they get old, get those new feathers. And I was talking about mother and dad and how that they're not able to do the things they used to do, but they love being in God's house. And when God comes and manifests himself in that little humble abode of their house over there on Hawthorne Avenue, when his presence come, oh, they're renewed like eagles with strength. Dad just mentioned to Becky, I believe this morning, if I'm not mistaken, when we were over there and had prayer with him last night, he said, I just felt like God touched me. I want you to know something, church. That's worth more than anything in this old world, is to know that you're in touch with the Almighty God. And when you need his strength and you need his touch, no matter what juncture of life that you're in, that he'll be there. Thank God he knows exactly what we need this morning hour. Thank the Lord he does. And we can just add this list to ours and join all together in thanking God for all the blessings and the joy that he showers upon us each and every day. But thirdly, let us notice and last, even though bad things happen to God's people, we can still praise God. But not everybody is sharing in joy and thanksgiving this morning. Some of you are suffering. You read our prayer list, you'll find that some are anticipating surgery and others with terminal illness, and some are struggling with family or financial problems. In fact, the whole truth we're knowing that almost everybody in this church this morning is suffering in one way or another, and if not today, then tomorrow. Some of you are going through things you've never gone through before in your life. We were at the restaurant the other day, and a couple before us was paying the bill. And she had told them they were senior citizens. She said, I'm not afraid to ask for that. I said, I need that discount. And she turned around to us and she said, you know, they talk about these golden years. They're not so golden sometimes. Well, I want to tell you something. Every one of us in our life may have to go through some things that we've never gone through before. Never gone through before. We're suffering one way or another. Was it not Job who said, man is born of a woman a few days old and full of trouble? Yet even through bad things that happen to God's people, we can give praise and thanksgiving to God. Why? Because the greatest difference between God's people and all the rest of the world is that we don't suffer alone. Yea, though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. We, children of God, have him with us to help us through our suffering and through our struggling of life that we go through. And I want to tell you something. You don't have to be old to struggle in life. Some of you this morning may just be starting out in life that are struggling. But I've got some good news for you. Hold on. If you can stand the pull, he'll pull you through. Tie a knot. Hold on. God's grace is sufficient. Be thankful for a God that loves us, even when things aren't going the way they ought to go. We're not the only ones struggling. We're not the only ones hurting. The people who never darkened the door of the church are hurting too. The people who never lift a voice in praise of thanksgiving to God are hurting too. The great difference is that when we hurt, God is there to help us through those difficult moments of life. Back in the 24th verse of the second chapter of the book of Exodus, it says, God heard their groanings and he remembered his covenant with Abraham, with Isaac, and with Jacob. You and I may forget the names that we were just told 5 minutes ago. Friends that we used to know and be part associated with our lives. You know, every once in a while, wife and I will be talking and we'll say, either she'll say or I'll say, you remember so-and-so? You remember they lived right beside it? Oh man, what in the world is their name? You ever done that? Huh? Well, I had a hard time this morning remembering Teresa's name. She's been here several times, but why in the world I couldn't think of Teresa for some reason, and I'm scrambling around here talking to this one and that one, and what's your name? I know her name, I just can't. Do you ever do that? Sure you do, but I want to tell you something. We're serving a God that never forgets our name. We're serving a God that doesn't have to think, well, oh, who is it? Call somebody on the phone and ask. No. He's the God that goes with us, and through everything that we go, we can depend upon him. He'll be there, regardless of what happens across our pathway. We can trust him. He will be there. Thank the Lord. God is saying, I hear every cry that comes from the lips of my people, every prayer from the depths of their hearts. I'm concerned about their tears and their suffering. I'm reaching down to rescue them. That's another good reason to be thankful, isn't it? It's been my experience when our children or our grandchildren are hurting that those are the times when we are the most able to communicate our love and concern for them. And because we can't stand to watch them hurting, we scoop them up in our arms and we do everything in our power to show them how much that we love them. And don't you think our God does the same thing? When we're in the midst of the battle of life and when we are hurting, God's there to pick us up and give us strength for the day. Well, this morning, if you're here and you're going through the trials of life, without the help of Jesus, I've got some good news for you. He loves you too. And he's interested in helping you as well as he's interested in helping his people. He wants everyone to come to know him in a personal way and be their God. You know, Jesus, he loves everyone. It makes no difference where they are in life. It makes no difference where they are in sin. Jesus loves every one of them. And this morning, he offers forgiveness to those that will only come and be willing to confess their sins to Jesus Christ. And on this coming Thursday, then you can thank the right person for the right things if you've totally surrendered your life over to Jesus Christ. Oh, church, we have a wonderful privilege this morning knowing Jesus in a very personal way, and he loves every one of us. Amen. Let us stand together. I wonder this morning, I remember pastoring a church, and someone just couldn't understand why that Brother Mary would always have an invitation. But I want to tell you why. We have no idea this morning who the Holy Spirit's been speaking to this week. They may have come this morning saying, if I just have an opportunity, I'm going to give my heart to Jesus. I want to give you that opportunity this morning. Just come and kneel at this altar and turn it over to Jesus Christ. And then you can thank the one whom is right to thank for the many blessings that he bestows upon each and every one. Amen. Let us not take Thanksgiving for granted. Let's thank God for all of his many, many manifold blessings. Everybody said amen. Praise God. Thank the Lord. Brother Kevin Wilhelm, would you dismiss us in prayer?